Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm about to present to you 2016 brand spanking new Skoda Octavia, and this is going to be full in-depth tour. This Octavia will start up, show the engine, go on some performance details, show you a bunch of the interesting features inside and out. And so here's the key. Let's start the engine. Let it run for a while. Flip key, lock, unlock, and trunk button. White exterior. Very nice color in my opinion. Solid doors. Very wide opening, it's almost like 90 degree, providing easy entry and exit. This car has two airbags, of course, for the driver and for the passenger. Two-ton interior, quite nice. Very good. Sound isolation. Nice. Three-spoke design steering wheel. Very thick. Your grips up top. High gloss black finish on the Skoda emblem. Five-speed silky smooth manual transmission on the top trim. Automatic is available and DSG. Part of the VW group. Alright guys, insert the key, then put your foot on the clutch and twist. Twist the key. Very nice. Instrument cluster. Very impressive startup. Quiet engine. This car comes equipped with electrically assisted power steering companion, very fluid steering wheel. Can do it with one finger, as you can see. Horn, very loud. Manual tilt and telescopic for the steering column to adjust to use this lever right there. It's quite easy, as you can see. Nice, you can find perfect position for yourself. Not bad. Alright guys, let's turn the headlight, rear fog light, high beam, Solus headlights, front windows are fully automatic in both direction, up and down, one touch as you can see, not bad. Your bar mirrors, they also heated left and right. And there is a joystick right there. Very good visibility. Not bad. Chrome door handles. Fake aluminum trim. Alright guys, let's open the hood and take a look at the exterior of this car. And actually, when the door is closed, you can open the hood. And when you open the door, you can do it with one hand. It's quite easy. This car missing power moonroof, and also as an option, I believe, available panoramic sunroof. Rear defrosting glass, your third brake light, very bright third brake light. Very nice looking tail lights. On a top trim, LED tail lights is available. Why is this red lights? Yeah, Tahak, single exhaust. This car missing rear parking assist. Factory steel rims with wheel covers, 15 inch, tires measuring 195/65. Front ventilated disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes. Pirelli all season tires. Mat flaps right there. LED turn signal lights next to the mirrors, very bright. Heated windshield wipers, this area. Halogen reflector headlamps. On the top trim, xenon projector headlamps is available. They're also adaptive. Daytime running lights, of course. Coral maxing grille, very nice looking. Huge Skoda emblem. And your Tahak, front Tahak right there. Very nice body lines. This car has inline 4, 16 valve, 1.6 liter, normal aspirated engine, produces 110 horsepower and 155 Nm of torque. Maximum speed of 190 km per hour, 0-6 time is 10.8 seconds. Combined consumption for this car is around 5.5 liter per 100 km. The car is front wheel drive and the fuel tank is around 50 liters. Independent McPherson strut suspension with iron roll bar up front and torsion bar out back. The Skoda Octavia is produced since 1996. The third generation Octavia was revealed on 11 December 2012. The Octavia features numerous so-called simply clever details. For instance, an ice scraper inside the fuel filler flap. Alright guys, right now take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion. Of course, most interesting part. Titan interior for the alarm. Your tweeters right there. And of course, main speakers, storage area, and bottle holder also lined. In velour, I believe, very nice. Soft armrest. Very nice attention to the details. This car feels very solid. You can find manual adjustment for the driver's seat sliding right there, your seat height and recline right there. Seats are quite comfortable, adjustable headrests, seat belts. Glove compartment for the driver, also padded. Onboard diagnostics right there. This knob right here adjusts half headlights. All right, guys, let's see what kind of noise this engine produce. careering. Engine, very quiet. Rev limit around 4,000 RPM. Very nice. Well, not bad indeed. Like I mentioned before, take the steering wheel. And here's your light indicator controls. Of course, high gloss back finish. And right now, all right, let's turn the air conditioning, because right now it's around 22 degrees Celsius. And here's your web controls right there. As you can see, your high intensity discharge headlamps, of course, is available, and intermittent wipers. Trip information, it's set temperature, it's brand new car, 6 kilometers only, and of course your digital clock up top, your digital speedometer, lapse time, distance to empty range, average and current fuel economy, warning, manual speeding, nice, and reset for the odometer right there. Nice. Overall build quality and all the materials in this car are very nice. You can find soft touch and hard touch, very interesting vans. Build quality is just amazing. And actually it not feels like a cheap VW. Not bad indeed. Your passenger airbag indicator right there and seatbelt warning right there. Interesting vans. Your infotainment screen, power button, of course, 8 speakers, 2 tweeters. Sounds pretty good, by the way. Radio, media, phone controls, high gloss black finish, as you can see, your setup, sound, and core. At set temperature, your digital clock, Bluetooth stream of audio, auxiliary USB, and SD card right there. Your different settings right here. Not bad. Bluetooth, mix, repeat. It's pretty much self-explanatory. Media, auxiliary, phone control, find phone, help, results, settings, and Bluetooth. Nice, very easy to use. Your general setup for the sound, volume, it's pretty much self-explanatory. Your balance, bass, mid-range, treble. Screen settings, once again sound, balance for instance. Very responsive touch screen display, screen, then time and date. As you can see, format, not bad indeed. All right, your language settings. Let's see what we got here. More keypad languages. All right, units, distance, miles, kilometers, speed, miles per hour, and kilometers, temperature, Celsius, Fahrenheit, volume. Not bad. Consumption, pressure. Very comprehensive system. Configuration wizard. Remove SD card safely and remove USB safely. Back to factory settings. Once again, Bluetooth. Not bad. Your system information. Copyright. Sweet. Very comprehensive system indeed. Sound adjustment and a car, as you can see. Vehicle status, very clear graphic, by the way. And different settings right here. Long term, since refueling and since start. General settings for the tires, lights, mirrors, opening and closing. Instrument cluster, time and date, unit, service, as you can see, inspection, oil change, service, and factory settings. That's pretty much it for this system. Quite easy to use, comprehensive. Your volume control, manual tuning, not bad, not bad indeed. Now here you can find your very easy to use air conditioning, your temperature adjustments, fan speed control, your different modes, face, knee, etc. As you can see, recycle settings, rear defrost, air conditioning, and 3-stage heated seats for the driver and for the passenger. High, medium, low, and off. Nice. Storage area down there, your USB and auxiliary integration, your central lock, turn off the RSR, traction control, RSR off, alright, 5-speed silky smooth transmission, light clutch, nice, and reverse, all the way down, and reverse, not bad. Brake, very light, cigarette lighter, two cup holders, your ashtray, storage area. Sadly, this car missing armrest, very good visibility. Everything's very nice to put together here. You can definitely feel this amazing Skoda quality. Manual dim rear view mirror, and of course, your map lights up top. Reading lights, nice. Microphone for hands-free, vent mirror, no illumination, car holder, grip handles up top, by 6'3" stature. These seats are quite nice, leg room is more than enough, shoulder room is okay, thigh support is pretty good. So guys, this Skoda Octavia is just amazing. I mean, inside and out, looks gorgeous, very tight suspension, extremely reliable. Just love it. Everything in this car just looks amazing. Sensitive brakes, interesting steering wheel, fuel economy with this 1.6 liter inline 4-16 valve engine. It's just amazing. A lot of adjustment. Not bad. Very impressive car indeed. Alright guys, right now let's shut her down. Let's grab the key and continue restore. Very stylish interior as well as the exterior. Not bad. And actually with my 6'3" stature, it's quite easy to get in and out. second row is also very roomy. It's like a mini limousine. Child safety locks. Materials do carry over. Soft armrest, as you can see, lined in velour, your main speakers and manual windows. Of course, your tweeters right there. Back seats easy to fold, 60-foot split, of course adjustable headrests, like so. To increase more cargo space, basically, chest anchors. But there is no armrest, no pass-through, seatbelt, and a back seats. Also has ISOFIX system right there, ISOFIX latch. Alright guys, with my 6'3 stature, it's quite easy to get in and out. Very thick panels, as you can see. Legroom is not an issue at all, and my headroom is pretty good. And there is no storage pockets, hook right there, and cut hook up top. Your illumination, interior illumination. Don't expect to find armrest in this car. Pretty good. Back visibility. Adjustable, of course. Headrests. Nice. Storage compartment right there. Quite nice seats, your center tunnel, huge center tunnel. Very nicely equipped car for its price, good warranty, stylish interior. Not bad indeed. Alright guys. Let's check trunk space, shall we? Surprisingly, guys, the trunk is enormous. As you can see. Extra hook right there. Your sure back hooks, cargo tie downs, your illumination. And down here, warning triangle will be right there. And down here, you can find your full size spare tire, tools, and jack. As you can see. Nice. And this ridiculous handle right there. As you can see, to close trunk. Fuel cap, ice scratcher. And your tire pressure. This car feels very solid. And you can find manual adjustment for the passenger seat minus seat height. Bar window right there. Glove box is not lockable. Very deep pen holder, also padded. Your, of course, cool glove box via air conditioning. Shelf right there, and shelf right there. And basically your manuals. Simply clever. That's your manuals. Whoops. That's called a Yeti. For your audio, it's all Russian specification, of course. Alright guys, let's take a good look at the owner's manuals of Skoda Yeti. So guys, for its price, this car is very nicely equipped. Extremely reliable engine, transmission, very interesting steering wheel, sensitive brakes. Not bad, not bad indeed. Way to go, Skoda. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2016 brand new Skoda Octavia. Thanks for watching and take care guys.